Hey friends, did you know that there is a wealth of messaging option in Azure, from Service Bus and events, IoT notification hubs, and more? That huge amount of services provides a lot of power for your application, and Azure Barry is going to help me understand it all today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Azure Barry, and we're going to learn about choosing Azure services for working with messages in your application. How are you, sir?
Very good. Thank you. You?
Lovely. I always enjoy learning from you and your very excellent slides and demos. Thanks for spending time with me today. What do you have?
Well, again, Azure is very, very big. Today we're going to try and figure out how to choose the services for working with messages in your application. So there are lots of options, obviously, for working with messages. And what I mean by working with messages is that you work with small pieces of data that you want to send from your application to another application. And an example can be you place an order on your website and you then make a message of that little order and put it on a queue so that it can be processed later. So you offload it. There are lots of other use cases for that as well. So let's first take a look at all the options that there are for working with messages in Azure. First one is Azure Storage Queues, which is a queuing mechanism, like I just explained. Second one is Azure Service Bus Queues, which is the same functionality. It's also a queue, but it has different specifications. And I'll explain what the difference is between the two in a later slide. There's also Azure Service Bus Topics, which is also a queue, but slightly different, where you have Azure Service Bus Queues. You put a message on the queue and one application takes it off for processing. In Azure Service Bus Topics, you put a message on the queue and then multiple applications can take that message off the queue for processing. And then you also have Azure Notification Hubs, which you can use to send push notifications like the ones you get from Facebook and all the other applications on your phone. But then with Azure Notification Hubs, it makes it simple to send just one message to Notification Hubs and it can send it to Android, iOS, Windows, and all sorts of other platform notification services without you having to write the plumbing to actually talk to those notification services. There's also Azure Event Grid, which allows you to subscribe to events and then push those events to somewhere. So for instance, you could subscribe to an event in your Azure storage when a blob gets uploaded and then use that event to, for instance, kick off an Azure function to process something. Then there's also Azure Event Hubs, which you can use to ingest massive amounts of messages and then push them off to be analyzed. A similar service is Azure IoT Hubs, which also allows you to take in a lot of messages and then have them analyzed. But Azure IoT Hub is different from Azure Event Hubs in that it can also communicate back. So it has the bidirectional messaging. As in, if you have an IoT device, you can receive messages from that IoT device, but you can also send messages to that IoT device and, for instance, reset it or shut it off. And then there is Azure Logic Apps, which is actually one of my favorite services because it's so easy to use. And you use it to create processes in Azure. So logical steps that are started from an input like a blob got uploaded or a tweet got sent. And then finally, there's the Azure SignalR service, which you use to connect clients together in real time and send messages to each other. An example of using this could be where you have an auction application, and then when the price for a certain item changes, you can use Azure SignalR service to update that price on all the clients on mobile, on web, on desktop, on your screen, whatever, in real time, in the exact same time, so that the price is always up to date everywhere. Now, these are a lot of services.
That is a lot.
That is a lot, yeah. I'm going to help you to make sense of this and to choose which ones you need in which scenario.
Cool, because they all have a reason. Like, it seems like a lot. It seems overwhelming. It seems like a cafeteria full of options, but they all have a reason to exist.
Absolutely, yeah. There is some overlap here and there, but let's see. So messages, like I said, are pieces of data that you use to convey something to applications or services. Now, messages can be messages of intent, which are usually commands. So you send a message to an application to do something. You want something to happen, like you want to increase the temperature on a thermostat, for instance. So you send a message, and you could get a message back for this. Services in Azure that you can use for this type of messages, so intent messages, are storage queues and also service bus queues and topics. So you can put a message on there and something can happen in an Azure function, let's say. IoT Hub and logic apps work also very well for this scenario. And also SignalR can be used for intent messages with commands. Now, another type of messages is facts. So we have intents and facts. And facts come in two different styles. And one is in discrete data, so a singular fact. It doesn't happen continually. It can happen often, but not continually. And could be something like a door opened or a door closed, and you want to convey that to another application or service. Now you could use Azure Event Grid for this, for instance, to subscribe to this fact and then send it to somewhere else to be processed. Or Azure SignalR service, like in the example of the auction service, where then the discrete fact that happened is that the price changed, for instance, and that you want to update that on all the screens. You can also use notification hubs to then push this event or the fact of this message to phones, for instance, as a push notification. So another type of facts is a stream of data. There could be a lot of facts, which is usually a continuous stream of data, which is related to each other. Like, for instance, temperature data in a temperature sensor that sends temperature data every second to your application. 23 degrees, 23 degrees, 23 degrees, which is not very useful, but in relation to each other, the data is useful because when a change happens, then you can say, well, the temperature went up or it went down. And a stream of data of facts you can process with Azure Event Hubs, which is perfectly capable to ingest a lot of messages like this and then send it off for analytics. And also IoT Hubs, which does kind of the same thing, but like I said, is bidirectional, so you can also send messages back to your devices. When you figure this out, you might also have questions about storage queues and service bus queues if you end up there, to see what the difference between the two is. Let's just dive into that. So storage queues versus service bus queues. They're both queue services, which kind of do the same thing. You put a message on there, another application takes it off and processes it. In the case of an Azure Service Bus queue, a message lives potentially longer than 7 days. And you can also guarantee the order in which messages come in and are read by applications that process it. There is features like duplicate detection, and your message size is 1 megabyte at most. Now, Azure storage queues, they have a message lifetime of a maximum of 7 days, so not longer. And the queue size of a storage queue can be very large, larger than 80 gigabytes, where service bus queues can only be 80 gigabytes, which is still pretty large. Storage queues come also with transaction logs, which is actually a feature of Azure Storage, where storage queues is then a feature of Azure Storage. And their message size is 64 kilobytes at maximum. Now, if you ask me, the biggest difference between these is Azure Service Bus queues is a more fancy queue with a lot more features, where Azure Storage queues is a very simple queue that you just use if you want the basic functionality of a queue. Let me just show that quickly in the Azure portal, because that might make this a bit more lively. Here in the Azure portal, I have a storage account, which is this one, which has queues, which we can see here. And here is one of those queues already. It's a very simple thing. And you can see here that I can just add a message with text and an expiration. And that's all. It's very simple. And here is a service bus. And this service bus has queues and topics. And here's one of those queues. And if I create a queue, you can already see that I have duplicate detection, dead lettering on message expiration, which means that messages that expire because they aren't read are automatically placed in another queue. And we have all sorts of other more advanced functionalities. And then there's also topics, which are basically the same mechanism as queues. But the main difference here is that topics have subscriptions. And subscriptions are then things that other applications can use, so multiple applications can use to subscribe to this queue, sort of to the topic, to get messages that they're interested in. These aren't loading. But as you can see, a subscription then is also a queue and has these more advanced features like dead letter sub queue as well.
That seems a lot more sophisticated, like there's a lot more opportunities to bake the business logic of the movement of these things from place to place into Azure itself, and you don't need to do that work in your application.
It is, absolutely. So it depends on your needs, obviously. There's also a price component in here as well, and a size component of messages as well. So it depends totally on your needs, but like you said, your service bus queues are more sophisticated than Azure storage queues.
Yeah. And the idea of being guaranteed ordering also seems like a very valuable feature.
Yeah. But not everybody needs that, of course. Mm-hmm. So let's compare these messaging options. We had service bus queues, and I also put storage queues in here as well. Service bus topics, event grid, event hubs, IoT hub, notification hubs, logic apps, and SignalR. So if you want to send a message to make something happen, like we just seen, we can use service bus queues and also storage queues, also service bus topics, IoT hubs, logic apps, and SignalR services. If you want to subscribe to and publish discrete events, then you can use the event grid and also notification hubs. So these discrete events, these facts that just happen occasionally, and also SignalR service in the example of the auction application. Mm-hmm. And if you want to analyze contextual data in bulk, so the stream of factual data, then you could use event hubs. And then for more specific scenarios, if you want to send a message to just one subscriber, then you would use the queue, so service bus and storage queue. And if you want to send a message to multiple subscribers, you would use the topics. But then you could also use all of the other services, which can basically send messages or have multiple applications process the messages that they receive. If you want to orchestrate a message-driven workflow, so a complete process, you use logic apps. And if you want to receive and send messages to IoT devices, which is very specific, you use IoT Hub. And then finally, if you want to send notifications to many devices over different protocols, to, for instance, Apple, iOS, Android, and Windows platform notification services, without having to write all of the plumbing to do so, you would use Azure Notification Hubs. So this filtering that we've just seen and these questions that you see here, hopefully they help you to make sense of all of the services in Azure that you can use for messaging in your application.
And certainly you can use these together, right? So notification hubs for mobile devices to send discrete events to many devices over different protocols that might have been created by or sourced by something that started in Service Bus, moved its way through event hubs, and then eventually into notification hubs. Is that right?
Oh, absolutely. I have many solutions that have most of these services actually working together in there. Yeah. And then use these different scenarios, because sometimes all of these scenarios are true for just one solution. Mm-hmm. That can definitely be true. Yeah.
Fantastic. This is a really good overview and a great table.
Yeah. So if you want to learn which other Azure services there are, you can go to this URL, which shows you all of the Azure services, not only the messaging services.
Fantastic. I appreciate you doing that, Azure Barry. I'm learning all about the wealth of messaging options that are available to me on Azure, and Azure Barry has just demystified a bunch of them for me today on Azure Friday.